juju. Interesting. Reminds me of juju beans. Speaking of juju beans, I never liked, like, what are those called? The beans, the little candy beans. Jelly beans. What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Justin, and today we're listening to Siouxsie and the Banshees with their song Spellbound. This is off of their album Juju, which was released in 1981. The band has come up so many times in the comments. I've had them on the list. There's a lot of bands on the list. You guys said this was a good song to start off with. I see that this is the first song off of their fourth album. So, you know, it's a pretty decent place to start at the beginning. Not the very beginning, like debut, but, you know, somewhere. What magic tricks do you guys know? Do you know any magic tricks? I did one a long time ago on the channel. I don't know. It was a simple little card trick. But I can also do this. Huh? The magic of editing. Anyways, you guys are more than welcome to join me on Twitter. Join me in the comments down below if you want. You can support the channel on Patreon. That was a really dumb magic trick. Let's do it. This is Siouxsie and the Banshees with Spellbound. Don't even know what type of band they are. Before I even talk, I've heard of them because of you guys, but I don't even know what genre I'm going to be listening to, so let's do it. It's always exciting.
From the cradle bars comes a beckoning voice that sings spinning. You have no choice.
Give me a little sample, give me a little taste, and you take away the ice cream. I like that. Siouxsie Sue, which is a really cool name. I love that name. I like her voice a lot. It almost has not a haunting tone to it, but a little bit. There's a certain atmosphere in her voice in which she's melodically yelling at me, but I like it. Drumming by Budgie. Yeah, Budgie. Is that the band Budgie? No. And he's drumming pretty fast too. I mean, he's going with it. I like the guitar tone as well. A lot of the song is really just like fast, like blazing guitar played by John. This song is kind of just blazing fast, especially with the guitar and the drums. But like I said, I like those moments where the drum breaks away, even within the repetition of certain sections. It's just really cool, and it's a really fun way of changing how the song structure feels, you know? It's interesting because the song stays the same tempo pretty much the whole thing, but it's the addition and the taking away of certain instruments that makes it change and sounds cooler. Like right here. Same pace, but just because of like how fast they're like hitting the guitar. Like they're just shredding it, you know? And of course the delivery even picks up a little more. It sounds like a melodic wailing that she's kind of doing. It's kind of cool, you know? I'll admit, I don't love this song, but as usually happens, I'm definitely interested in more. You know, I would like to hear maybe a little more space in the song. You guys know, I'm claustrophobic sometimes when it comes to music. I like big open spaces, like in that one episode of Harold, when they're in the subway and there's the people across and they're like, think, big open spaces. Remember that episode? Maybe not. But but that's what I like. So I would have liked maybe something like that, a spacey break in the middle. But as it was a nice, definitely a nice send-off into the album. The lyrics, from the cradle bars comes a beckoning voice. It sends you spinning. You have no choice. You hear laughter cracking through the walls. It sends you spinning. You have no choice. You hear laughter cracking through the walls. It sends you spinning. You have no choice. Following the footsteps of a ragdoll dance, we are entranced, spellbound. Following the footsteps of a ragdoll dance, repeating those lyrics. And don't forget when your elders forget to say their prayers, take them by the legs and throw them down the stairs. Okay, so I'm getting childhood in this. From the cradle bars, right, comes a beckoning voice that sends you spinning, you have no choice. You're a baby. You're a baby in the cradle. You're at the bars, you can't get out. And the beckoning voice, parents, right? You hear laughter cracking through the walls. It sends you spinning. You have no choice. Like, you're just at the whims of your parents. Don't forget when your elders forget to say their prayers for them and take them by the legs and throw them down the stairs. Are we Chucky? Are we Children of the Corn? What are we? Are we Damien? When you think your toys have gone berserk, it's an illusion. You cannot shirk. Okay, now we're getting some, like, what is that, that other movie, Small Soldiers or Little Soldiers or whatever that one, where the toys are alive. Following the footsteps of a ragdoll dance, we are entranced. I mean, I was kind of following it with that. I'm kind of still in that childhood phase, kind of looking at the world, but like an evil child, something? I don't know. But let me know what you guys thought. You can join me on Twitter. You can join me in the comments down below. Hope you're having a fantastic day, guys. And I will talk to you tomorrow. Bye. And if there's like a kid behind you as you're going down the stairs and he's just kind of giving you like a really weird look, just maybe don't go down the stairs just yet. Or if you do, go backwards. No, but then if you go backwards, you'll definitely fall. And then the kid's going to stand at the top of the stairs and just like stare at you. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. I'll talk to you tomorrow, guys. Beware evil children. Bye.